present over here. Today, we have gathered here for the British Council ISA project, that is, Each One, Plant One, Go Green. As we all know, trees are an essential part of our nature, and even we can't survive without them. They provide an extensive range of benefits to everybody, our environment, and to the rest of the world. In the same breath, life without trees leads to non-existence. In the first place, trees provide the world with a steady supply of oxygen and purified air, which is very essential to life's existence. To save them is a necessity more than a duty. But we humans are so cruel and self-centered that we fell them recklessly. Keeping this view in mind, we are here for the English elocution based on the theme Each One, Plant One, Go Green. Poetry is language at its most distant and most powerful. So let's invite Sumit to recite his poem, Trees Are the Kindest Things.
Good afternoon. Trees are the kindest things I know. They do not harm, they simply grow and spread a shade for sleepy cows and gather birds among their boughs. They give us fruit in leaves above and woods to make our houses of, and leaves to burn on Halloween, and in spring new buds of green. They are the first when day is begun to touch the beams of the morning sun. They are the last to hold the light when the evening changes into night. And when the moon floats on the sky, they hum a drowsy lullaby of sleepy children long ago. Trees are the kindest things I know. Thank you.
Wow, you recited it so well. Each one, teach one to plant a tree. One or two, it depends on you. Now, Garima is coming to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. Each one, teach one to plant a tree. Each one, teach one to plant a tree. One or two, it depends on you. Trees give us oxygen to breathe. Trees give us fruits to eat. So let's plant a tree, let's plant a life, let's save a tree, let's save a life. We will teach to one and each, and we will plant a tree. Together let's make the world green, let's make the monument full of leaves. Each one teach one to plant a tree, each one teach one to plant a tree. Thank you.
Poetry is the rhythmical creation of beauty and words. Here comes Tanzil to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. Have you seen the green, green trees? Have you seen the green, green trees? They clean the air and cool the breeze. They clean the air and cool the breeze. Smoke and dust and garbage be. Smoke and dust and garbage bee, and dirty water makes us ill, and dirty water makes us ill. So let us promise to be clean, so let us promise to be clean, to make our surrounding fresh and green, to make our surrounding fresh and green. Thank you.
Give her a big round of. Now, Unnati is coming to recite her poem on the same.
Good afternoon. What makes a garden grow, grow, grow? Lots of folk with a rake and hoe. Seed gently planted in a row that makes a garden grow, grow, grow. What brings the seedling up from the ground? Rain from the sky coming down and down. Light yellow sunbeam shining around. Help bring the seedling up from the ground. Help bring the seedling up from the ground. Thank you.
Thank you, Unnati. Let's invite Janvi to recite her poem on the sea.
In the heart of a seed, buried deep, so deep, a tiny plant, a fast asleep, weep, weep. outside world might be, outside world might be. Thank you.
Now, Kunj is coming to recite his poem, Plants and Trees So Green.
Good afternoon. Plants and trees, so green, so green, so green, so green. The kitchen is the leaf and fruit is the chief. They give us flower to decorate and also to celebrate. They give us paper from their woods and they are found in woods. With their help, we can make whatever we want, from a rubber band to pen. We don't need to pay any tax or fees to borrow from our lovely trees. They protect us from diseases that could make us ill. All the carbon dioxide, they always take in. Some people cut trees for things like tables and chairs. Not mind what pollution they are doing to the air. Forests are turning from green to brown. Animal faces are always with a frown. So let's make this place from brown to green by planting more saplings and trees. By planting more saplings and trees. Thank you.
Trees are the earth's endless effort to speak to the listening heaven. Here comes Nikita to recite her poem, Five Little Seeds.
Good afternoon. Five little seeds, five little seeds. Three will make flowers and two will make weeds. Under the ground and under the snow. Under the ground and under the snow. Five little seeds are waiting to grow. Five little seeds are waiting to grow. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Vanshika is coming to recite her poem, Save the World, Plant a Tree.
Good afternoon. Save the world, plant a tree. For each one's a plant tree. Responsibility starts with you. You actions, the things you do. We are one and the same. Killing a tree gives no man fame. They are alive, they breathe. They feel pain, they live. Save the world, plant a tree. For each one's a plant tree. Go green, stop global warming. This is not a point, a warning. Trees are our friends. Let's not treat them as friends. It's in a deplorable state, her health. Show a little compassion for Mother Earth. Show a little compassion for Mother Earth. Thank you.
Thank you, Vanshika. Poetry is when an emotion has found its thought and a thought has found words. Now, Richa is coming to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. A tree is like our mother. Whenever we give, bestows love and blessings on us. It never let us fall, as it treats as its own soul. It gives everything it can give. It provides its oxygen to live. Then why are we treating a tree in such a rude way? Why are we cutting a tree like a hungry devil? It only destroys our mother earth, but also decreases humans and animals' life. A tree that looks at God whole day and joins its sleeping hand to pray. That saved my life. We can save many lives by planting a single seed. So at last, I wanted to recommend you all one point lesson. That is, plan today to live tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you, Risha. It was truly a captivating performance. Here comes Priya with a wonderful poem.
Good afternoon. A plant will grow from a tiny seed. Some water and sun is all you need. First the roots grow underground. They suck up minerals from all around. Then come stems, some tall, some stout. And next the branches spread out. Leaves growing on shapes and sizes. What this new life as it rises. Flowers bloom from buds on stem. They are prettiest precious gems. Some plants give us juicy fruit. Some have vegetables at the root. New seeds travel to and fro by wind and water on the go. And the cycle keeps on going. Soon new stems and leaves are shed. Soon new stems and leaves. the shape. Thank you.
You recited it so well. Now, let's invite Preksha to recite her poem on the scene.
Good afternoon. Kids are like seeds you plant in the soil. Each takes patience, nurturing and toil. You are a great teacher, planting seeds of knowledge. Just look at us to tell. Now plant these seeds over each of us, so they grow bright to remind you of us. So they grow bright to remind you of us. Thank you.
Now, Sapna is coming with a wonderful poem. I think I shall know.
Good afternoon. I think I shall never see. I think I shall never see a poem lovely as a tree. A poem lovely as a tree. A tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against the sweet of growing crest. A tree that prays at good old day and lifts her leafy arms to pray. A tree that may in summer be a nest of robins in a hair. Poems are made by fools like me. Poems are made by fools like me. But only God can make a tree. But only God can make a tree. Thank you.
Thank you, Sapna. Poetry is the rhythmical creation of beauty and words. Here comes Bhumi with her wonderful poem, Plant a Seed.
Good afternoon. Plant a seed, watch it grow for sure you live. What you sow to each one is what we need to do. You helping me and me helping you. Everyone on this earth has a significant purpose. Tap into your senses, you will find it is worth it. Investing each other, planted positive seed, help each other along the way. This is what we need, it's a life. See, teach a plant in the soil. Each takes patience, nurturing and toil. Thank you.
Our tree has a wonder at its most still and most powerful. Now, Palak is coming with a wonderful poem, I Took the Seed One Day.
Good afternoon. I took the seed one day. About a month ago, I put the seed in the soil. I hope that it would better to grow. I poured a little water to make the soil right. I put the pot upon the sill where the sun gave its light. Where the sun gave its light. I checked the pot most every day. I checked the pot most every day and turned it into once or twice. Turned it into once or twice with a little care and water. I had it to grow it nice. I had him to grow it nice. Thank you.
Wow, Palak, you decided it so well. Now, Bhumi is coming with a wonderful poem.
Trees can be short, trees can be tall. Whatever kind, I like them all. They give us oxygen, they give us air. We give them love, we give them care. From berries to cherries, from apples to grapes, they give us different fruits and growing different shapes. They need water, soil, space and light. We give them those things day and night. So today, we all say hooray for the trees' special day, which is called the Arbor Day. Thank you.
Trees are our best friends. Now, let's invite Preeti to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. Our best friends are trees, as they give a shape for me. In that shape, we all can play feuds and can eat lots of yummy fruits. They give fodder for cattle, enough for them, so they cannot battle. The fresh air goes to man, very necessary gas called oxygen. They give wood for wood cutter to sell, and the flowers give us a pleasant smell. But in spite of so many things given by trees, we still cut trees. Don't cut trees, save trees and plant trees. Thank you.
Thank you. has found words. Here comes Pigu with a wonderful poem.
Good afternoon. I see you are a seed. I see you are a seed. Tell me, what do you need? Tell me, what do you need? I need some soil to grow. I need some soil to grow. And then the sun to glow. And then the sun to glow. Water to make me wet. Water to make me wet. Air for my leaves to get. Air for my leaves to get. Space for my roots to spread. Space for my roots to spread. Now I am a plant. Now I am a plant. Thank you.
Thank you, Katie. Now, Aditi is coming with this wonderful poem, Plant the Tree to Save the World.
Good afternoon. Plant the tree to save the world. Plant the tree to save the earth. Trees provide a shelter and food, cleans up the air and makes it good. Trees protect us from hot sun rays, cools up the grass and cools up the wind. Trees bring clouds and trees bring rain. Let them flourish in our land. Let them flourish in our land. Trees add beauty to a place with its richness and its grace. So come dear children, where you have been, plant the tree and just go green. Plant the tree and just go green. Thank you, have a nice day.
Give him a big round of applause. Now, I invite Rashi to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. Save the world, plant a tree. For each one job, plant a tree. Responsibility starts with you. You action the things you do. We are one and the same. Killing a tree give no one pain. They are alive, they breathe. They feel pain, they rest. Save the world, plant a tree. For each one job, plant a tree. Go green, stop the warming. This is not a poem of warning. Trees are our friends, let's not treat them as pain. It's the deplorable state. Her health, show little compassion for mother. Her health, show little compassion for mother. Thank you.
It was a wonderful performance. Now, I invite Bhavika to recite her poem. There is a special daddy.
Good afternoon. There's a very special garden where the plants of family grow. Nurtured by the kindness and concern that one show. The roots are cherished families of good deeds in the past. The branches stand the promises that souls endure the last. It's a place of peace and beauty where bright new hopes can start. It's memory lonely garden that soothes the hurting heart. That soothes the hurting heart. Thank you, Anna Mister.
Now I invite Sifra to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. In the heart of a seed bird deep so deep, the little plant leaf fast and sleep. Weak, weak, set the sunshine and creep to the light. Weak, weak, set the voice of raindrops bright. The little plant heard and it rose to see what the wonderful outside world might be. What the wonderful outside world might be. Thank you.
Wow, it was really a captivating performance. Now I invite Bhumi to recite her poem.
दो भूमिज थी ना एक सेकंड
हियर नेहा इज कमिंग विद अ वंडरफुल पोएम
गुड आफ्टरनून ट्रीज कैन बी शॉर्ट ट्रीज कैन बी टॉल व्हाटएवर काइंड आई लाइक देम ऑल दे गिव अस ऑक्सीजन दे गिव अस एयर वी गिव देम लव We give them care. We take care of each as if they were our own. From their seedling to fully grown. From berries to cherries. From apples to grapes. They give us different fruits and grow in different shapes. With their colorful leaves and long brown trunk. We know that these beautiful trees are not junk. They need water, soil, space and light. We give them those things day and night. So today, we all say hooray. Thank you.
Thank you, Nina. It was Now I invite Asta to recite her poem.
Good afternoon. Today I have our class 6D. Plants and trees, plants and trees, so green, so green. The kitchen is the leaf, root is the cheek. They keep the flowers to decorate and also to sell. With their help, we can make whatever we want. From a rubber band to pen, we don't need to pay tax or fees. To borrow from our lovely trees, to borrow from our lovely trees. They protect us from diseases, they protect us from diseases. That would make us ill. All the carbon dioxide, they always take in. All the carbon dioxide, they always take in. Some people cut trees for things like table and chair, not knowing what pollution they are doing to the air. Thank you.
Thank you, Asta. Now I invite Anjali with her beautiful poem.
Good afternoon. Plant a tree, plant a tree. If when I'm gone, the woods on. If when I'm gone, the woods on. Then plant a tree, then plant a tree. Some ivy tree can be, some ivy tree can be. Me green with leaves, me green with leaves. So read it and be, and full of leaves, my monument. Be and full of leaves, my monument. So ever be of tuneful melody, so ever be of tuneful melody. My monument will be a sight most brave. My monument will be a sight most brave. Trees planted everywhere. Trees planted everywhere. Keep in mind that some ivy tree can be made green with leaves. Made green with leaves. And then have a nice day.
Thank you, Anjali. Now I invite Lakshmi with her melodious poem.
Good afternoon. The oak is called the king of trees. The aspen quivers in the breeze. Poplar grow up straight and tall. The peach tree spread along the wall. The sky moon gives you pleasant shade. The willow drops in watery glen. The willow drops in watery glen. The fir tree useful gives beach amidst the forest cliff. Beach amidst the forest cliff. Thank you.
You have a big round of applause. Now I invite Mayam with his beautiful poem on the sea.
Good afternoon. Little green seeds, little brown seeds, small and round, slipping quietly underground. Down comes the raindrop, sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle. Up comes the rainbow, twinkle, twinkle, twinkle. Little brown seeds, way down below, up through the earth, they grow, grow, grow. Up through the earth, they grow, grow, grow. Little green leaves grow one by one. They hold up their heads and look at the sun. They hold up their heads and look at the sun. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Trees provide an extensive range of benefits to everybody, our environment, and to the rest of the world. Here comes Kirti to recite her poem on the same.
Good afternoon. In the heart of a seed, in the heart of a seed, buried deep, so deep, a tiny plant lay fast asleep. Wait, said the sunshine, and creep to the light. Wait, said the voice of the raindrops bright. The little plant heard, and it rose to see what the wonderful outside world might be. What the wonderful outside world might be. Thank you.
Thank you, Kirti. Trees are very essential to life's existence. Now I invite Kunal to recite his poem.
Good
afternoon. A plant will grow from a tiny seed. A plant will grow from a tiny seed. Some water and sun is all you need. Some water and sun is all you need. First the roots grow underground. They suck up minerals from all around. Then come stems, some tall, some stout. And next the branches spread about. Leaves grow in all shapes and sizes. Watch this new life as it rises. Some plants give us juicy fruit. Some have vegetables at the root. New seeds travel to and fro by wind and water on the go. And the cycle keeps on going. Soon new stems and leaves are showing. Soon new stems and leaves are showing. Thank you.
Thank you. Wow, you started it so well. Now I invite Pal to recite her poem. Have you seen green, green trees?
Good afternoon. Have you seen the green, green trees? Have you seen the green, green trees? Have you seen the green of the trees? Have you seen the green of the trees? Cleaning the air and cooling the breeze. Cleaning the air and cooling the breeze. Depends on the trees. Depends on the trees. Smoke and dust, garbage spill. Smoke and dust, garbage spill. And dirty water makes us ill. And dirty water makes us ill. So let's promise to be clean, to keep our environment fresh and green. To keep our environment fresh and green. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Now invite Yash to recite this poem, Save the World, Plant a Tree.
Good afternoon all. Save the world, plant a tree. For it, bunch of plant tree. Responsibility starts with you. Do action the things you do. Do action the things you do. We are one and the same. Killing a tree and give no man pain. We are alive, they breathe. They feel pain, they breathe. They feel pain, they breathe. Trees are our friends. Let's treat them as friends. It is in a deplorable state her health. Show a little compassion for the Mother Earth. Show a little compassion for the Mother Earth. Save the world, plant a tree for the bunch of plant tree. Go green, stop global warming. This is not a poem award. This is not a poem award. Thank you and have a sparkling day.
Thank you. Yes, Abhi. Trees are an important part of our life. To save them is a necessity more than a duty. Now, Pari is coming to do a wonderful poem, Plant and Trees So Green.
Good afternoon. Plants and trees are so green, so green. The kitchen is the leaf, the roots are the chief. They give us plant to decorate and also for celebrate. They give us paper from their wood, that is only finding their wood. They protect us from diseases that would make us ill. And all the carbon dioxide they always take in. Some people cut trees for the things like table and chair, not knowing what pollution they are doing to the air. Forests are turning from green to brown. Animal faces are always with a frown. So let's make this place from brown to green by planting more saplings and trees. By planting more saplings and trees. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Keisha is coming to the point. As lovely as a tree.
I think I shall never see a poem as lovely as a tree. A tree whose dewy mouth is spread against the earth's sweet fine breath. A tree that looks at God all day and lifts her leafy arm to pray. A tree that may in summer wear a nest of frogs in her hair. Upon whose bosom snow has lain, who intimately lived with them. Poems are made by fools like me, but only God can make a tree. But only God can make a tree. Thank you.
Thank you, Krishna. It's a glorious poem. The hills and mountains are inviting.
Good afternoon. The hills and mountains are inviting. The forests and valleys are amazing. I wish I could live here forever or come often to sit by the gushing river. Nature's beauty is not temporary. It lasts forever and comes when I'm ready. I admire all this and forgot all my worries when everyone just runs and hurries. When everyone just runs and hurries. Thank you.
Thank you, Kartik. That is coming to the wonderful poem, Little Brown Seeds.
Good afternoon. Little brown seeds, so small and brown, are sleeping quietly underground. Down comes a raindrop, sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle. Little brown seeds, so small and brown, are sleeping quietly underground. Out comes a rainbow, twinkle, twinkle, twinkle. Little brown seeds, so small and brown, are sleeping quietly underground. Little brown seeds, way down below, up to the earth they grow, grow, grow. Little green leaves, come one by one, they hold their head and look at the sun. Little brown seeds, so small and brown, are sleeping quietly underground, are sleeping quietly underground. Thank you.
Thank you, Mama. You recited it so well. Trees are an essential part of our nature. Without them, we can't imagine our future. Now, Isha is coming to recite her poem on the same.
Trees are essential part of our nature. Without them, we can't imagine our future. Trees, so beautiful. They provide us many things like fruits and flowers. Trees carry clouds and bring rain showers. They give us oxygen and absorb carbon dioxide. Trees prove to us very helpful. But don't you think we should be careful? Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you. Now I invite Ishika to recite her melodious poem on the same.
Good afternoon. Trees are truly so altruistic. They provide solution. Trees are to many so problem. They provide solution and make the environment green by dwindling pollution. They survive extreme condition and bring the rain. But we cruel human just give them pain. They provide herbal medicine. They provide herbal medicine to us. But we cruel human just give them the pain. Do not cut trees. They are imperative. So let them persist. If you wish to live, do not cut trees, they are imperative. So let them persist if you wish to live. Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, Ishika. It was truly a captivating performance. Thus, understanding the importance of trees around us enables us to care and nurture them all throughout our lives, as well as to perform initiatives of propagating their existence through tree planting. As the noted American poet Lucy Larcom had once said, he who plants a tree, plants a home. We ought to love trees, plant trees, and let trees be our pillar partners while living life. Indeed, a life without trees doesn't only rob us appreciating the beauty of nature, but also snatches our privilege from delightfully experiencing the uses and benefits of God's wonderful creation.